Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Welcome everyone to this Mass, celebration of the Eucharist. And our intention for today is for Daniel Sanchez Sr., requested by George and Soyla Axiata. We begin under the power of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirits.
And as we come to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sinfulness and ask the Lord to come with his loving grace and mercy.
You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant us so to celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion, that we may merit to receive your pardon. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity to the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
reclining at table with his disciples, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, "Amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." The disciples looked at one another at a loss at whom he meant. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out whom he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, "Master, who is it?" Jesus answered, "It is the one to whom I hand the morsel after I have dipped it." So he dipped the morsel and took it and handed it to Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot. After Judas took the morsel, Satan entered him. So Jesus said to him, "What you are going to do, do quickly." Now, none of those reclining at the table realized why he said this to him. Some thought that since Judas kept the money back, Jesus had told him, "Buy what we need for the feast, or to give something to the poor." So Judas took the morsel and left at once, and it was night. When he had left, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and he will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me, and as I told the Jews, where I am going, you cannot come. So now I say to you." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, where are you going?" Jesus answered him, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, though you will follow later." Peter said to him, "Master, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." And Jesus answered him, "Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me three times." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as we continue our worship of God in a very special way during this week, you know, during Holy Week, you know, it is a time to reflect. It is a time to meditate. It is a time to live, you know, the passion of Christ. It's very important that we do that, because if we really look at the world and the situation in the world, I believe that that has been forgotten for a long time. Nobody could even say cares or pays attention to that anymore. But if we are true followers, this is the time that God has set apart for us to do that. You know, in the scriptures today, very beautiful, but in the gospel, you know, Jesus is getting ready to institute the Eucharist and the priesthood. He's getting ready to do that. Two things very beautiful. You know, the priesthood of the church, and also the church itself, the sacraments, especially the Holy Eucharist. He's getting ready to do that. But then there's something else that's going to happen. And it is happening, you know, right before those two institutions take place. And what could happen? What happened? And as we listen to the gospel today, you know, we hear about, you know, what happened. But when Jesus speaks about what is about to happen, you know, he's speaking about the will of God. And to do the will of God is to glorify God. It's to glorify God. How often have we said, "Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, God." I wonder how many people are going to thank God after the coronavirus is over. How many people will really, actually, thank God and not man, not world leaders, not anything, but God. See? But that is where God is glorified. But Jesus is going to glorify God, his Father, by what? By entering into his passion, saying yes.
yes
to the will of God.
Yes, Lord. Because he asked the Lord a couple of times in the Garden of Gethsemane, you know, if it is your will, you know, don't let me drink this cup. Like, say, I don't want to drink this cup, but not my will be done, but your will. See, so Jesus is about to enter to his suffering and pain for our salvation, which will glorify God, and God will glorify Jesus. You know, God is asking Jesus to do something that is glorification, and Jesus is responding, yes, and that is glorification. For the Father and the Son, you know, are glorified in God's will altogether. And it all begins, you know, as we read in the Gospel today, it begins, you know, that is going to be beautiful. But it all begins with betrayal and denial. Betrayal and denial. You know, we don't have to go too far to try to figure out what that is, because we have all of us have been betrayed at one time. All of us have been in denial. Someone has denied us at one time. But let us also turn that around, you know, because we have betrayed someone at one time or another. We have denied, you know, someone at one time or another. And that is awful. You can take what it does to a marriage, unfaithfulness, what it does to the marriage, the children, the family. It destroys it completely. Betrayal. Denial. Friendship. How many friends do we have that do not have anymore? Because of things that were said, gossip, like accusation, and things like that. But those are terrible things. And this is how it all begins. You know, as we're celebrating this Holy Week, the Passion of Christ. You know, and not doing a good Christian job is denial, it is betrayal. You know, not doing a good Christian job. You know, when God sends us, you know, we don't know. We usually put it away later, we'll call tomorrow and see what happens. We always, you know, wait. And when God, you know, calls us, you know, we don't come. We don't. So Jesus is our example of obedience, you know, to the Father. No matter how hard or how difficult the calling may be, as Christians, we should always say yes to the Father's will. Always say yes, no matter how hard or how difficult it may be. And it will get difficult at times in our lives. So let us remember that. And after Jesus took the morsel, Satan entered him. I was reading this and thinking about it and meditating. The 12 apostles were there. Jesus was there. That was 13, and Satan. 14 altogether. Wow. You know, before Jesus, you know, took communion, you know, he was fine. He was okay, even though he was a thief, you know, but he hadn't committed the greatest of sins yet. He hadn't done yet, you know. But after he took communion, it says Satan entered right after he received. Now he was ready to commit the evil, you know, that he had planned. Because Jesus told him, go quickly and do what you're going to do. And as we enter in, you know, as we listen to that, we say, what did Jesus tell him? He gave him permission to betray him. He gave him permission to betray him. Yeah? Go and do what you are going to do. We have to remind ourselves in our sinfulness. Yes, God doesn't want us to do that in the sense of the Holy Spirit to remind us. No. But if we're going to do it, the door is wide open. Go ahead. It doesn't stop us because of our free will that we have. You know, the same thing can happen to us at times. You know, when we come and we receive communion, you know, with an evil intention. A friend of mine, I went to see in jail, he was put in jail, and I asked him, came to Mass, received communion, and that night, his wife goes to the grocery store, buys groceries, she's coming out, and he unloads the whole barrel shotgun on her.
intention they had to kill his wife. He's in prison for the rest of his life.
And it also brought attention to mind. I could talk about people, a lot of these things I've heard from people, but maybe not only. Long time ago, I remember I used to go to Mass on Friday, go to confession. And right after Mass, because I came with an evil intention, I did not come with a good intention. I would confess my sin, but my confession was not good, because my intention was evil. Right? And what was my intention? I'm going to the bar. I'm going to the bars. Yeah, I'm going with my friends. I'm going to the drugs. We're going to get drunk. We're going to fight with gang members. We're going to do all of those things. And I came to Mass right before I left, and I did that. And I can hear the words of Christ telling me also, go quickly and do what you're going to do. And nobody saw me until Monday or Tuesday morning. Not my family, not my children, nobody. Sometimes I was in jail. But I came to Mass with an evil intention. And that's when Satan will come right into us, and then we will do the evil of our intention. We have to be careful, we have to be careful. That's why we are called to forgive, to reconcile, to not hold a grudge. We are called to love all the world. So those two examples have been our reflection, and also what happened in the last year. And during this Holy Week, we need to be ready. You know, we need to be ready, you know, the Passion of Christ. Every day we should read, you know, the long scripture that we read on Sunday, Palm Sunday, we should read that every day. Read that every day, read that every day. Meditate upon it. And also be thankful to God for what Jesus did to glorify our Heavenly Father. Amen.
Amen. We now gather in the spirit of prayer to present our needs.
Today, as a people, as a family, as a church of God, let us thank Almighty God for His Holy Catholic Church. Because here at Mass, and every time that we come to church, it's where we remember that God has done for us, that Jesus has done for us. We remember the church and the Holy Sacraments. We remember our salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for God's holy priesthood throughout the world. Today, let us remember Pope Francis, Michael, our bishop, Father David, the priesthood of tomorrow. Let's pray for our Don Francisco, and all the men in preparation and study to become priests. And also Concha, an engaged from our marriage, you know, studying to become a religious. These are the people that will be here tomorrow after we are gone. So we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Also, as Catholics and as Christians, let's look at ourselves as we come to Mass today, we continue to come to Mass, we continue to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. Let us come with a good intention. The greatest intention that we can come with, love of God and love of neighbor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Today, let us share all those good intentions that we have in our hearts with all of the people that we meet today. I know we're not supposed to go out, but we do need to go get groceries or prescriptions or something. But if we meet people, even from a distance, share with them the love of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray to the Lord and remember the holy souls of purgatory, the faithful departed, members of our family that have gone before us, our lady parishioners, members that have gone before us, and all that are dying now, especially those that are dying from the corona viruses. We want to pray for their husbands, their wives, and their children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now you may voice your intention for the one in the silence of the heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We now ask the blessed mother to join us in our prayers through her intercession as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Now that the gifts have been prepared, my friends, let us pray that this, our sacrifice, and the very sacrifice of our lives, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice for our hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his creatures.
Amen. Look favorably, O Lord, on these offerings of us, your family, and to those who make partakers of these sacred gifts, grant a share in their fullness. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts,
heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered into his passion willingly, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. He then gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks and praise, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all people, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. Behold, my friends, the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, us, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy with the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Today we pray especially for Daniel Sanchez Sr. We also remember Benjamin Rivera. We pray for all those who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Lord God, have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Juan Diego, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, my friends, we come together as one to pray in the words that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, peace I leave you, it is my peace that I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord always be with you.
And with your spirit, let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us patience.
Behold, my friends, Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy you should enter into my house. Only say this word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you have fed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come upon you and make with you forever.
Amen. Let us all go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.